I was playing lacrosse in gym, and I sort of got hit in the leg. I didn't really get an infusion for it because I didn't think it was that bad. But it swelled up a lot, and I missed like a week of school.
For patients with severe hemophilia, they don't tend to have any bleeding symptoms in the first 6 to 9 months of their life, but after that is when they start to bleed. And the bleeds that they tend to get are bleeds into their joints.
Well, I was diagnosed when I was 7, and like it was because of the first bleed that I had in my knee. I was playing soccer and got kicked in the knee. It swelled up a ton, and they put a cast on it, and then ended up draining blood right out of the kneecap. So they just stuck a needle and pulled out a couple syringes full of blood, and then put a cast on it again. And that really like affected me, because I can still remember that. I was at school for about a couple months and just couldn't do anything really. Like I would stay inside during recess and couldn't go outside with my friends. And so that was probably the biggest bleed that I can remember.
The most common joint bleeds that we see are knees, ankles, and elbows. And blood is very corrosive to the cartilage. The more bleeds you have, that joint space decreases. The cartilage, instead of being nice and smooth like a drinking glass, becomes very pitted and has rough edges, so your joint doesn't operate nice and smoothly.
Usually it depends on the bleed, but some limitation in range of motion. And we do know from more recent literature that, especially if you take weight on a joint that has blood in it, that you can actually cause direct damage to the cartilage lining of the bones. So besides the damage that could occur sort of later, this can occur quite quickly. So especially in the first couple of days where there's a fair bit of blood in the joint, we want to make sure the weight is off your joint. So you'd be using the crutches, not taking any weight, until you see that the swelling is almost gone.
But they also will get bleeds into their muscles, particularly the muscles in your thighs and your calves and in your arms. But occasionally they can have more serious bleeds, such as a bleed into the head. It's quite a rare event, but it can occur.
It's more internal bleeding that's the issue, particularly into, you know, the joints, like elbows, knees, and ankles, but also, you know, your vital organs kind of in the inside, and also head bleeds. That's like the number one thing that hemophiliacs should be concerned about.
If it's internally, then it's going to be like swelling, it's going to feel hot. It's definitely going to be painful.
We want to stop that bleeding as soon as possible, and that's partly why we teach families to home infuse, because as soon as you suspect a bleed, treat it right away, then call your hemophilia team and say, hey, this is what has happened. They'll often like come in, or they'll say, do a second dose tonight and we'll see you tomorrow.
As far as talking with my son about whether or not he's having a bleed, I always try to reassure him that you're never wrong in coming to us whether or not you have a bleed.
After you have a treatment, you do feel like a slight difference, because you feel like, okay, like everything is being repaired. So like even if you thought you had like a minor cut or like a minor thing and you were treating like a major bleed, you'd think that all the minor things are getting fixed up and repaired, so you kind of feel like better after.
If I could change one thing about hemophilia, probably the pain and swelling of it. So if I get like a joint bleed, it wouldn't swell up or hurt as much. It would just like swell up a little and hurt a little.